In the previous movie, we streamlined the foot controls by rigging a smart foot roll attribute, combining adjustable heel, ball, and toe lifts. In this movie, we'll add some more controls to accommodate the foot's complete range of motion. Start by opening the file Character Rigging, Part 21 Start, or by using your file from the previous lesson. Now that we've handled the intricacies of the primary foot roll mechanics, we can turn our attention to more complementary functions. First, we need the ability to tilt the foot side to side. We could do this by just rotating our left foot control, but that would affect our rotation axes and make the foot harder to plant. Instead, let's use some rotation pivots just like we did to control the heel, ball, and toe IK handles in Part 19. Create a pair of locators and rename them Inner Foot Loc and Outer Foot Loc. Position them on each side of the foot where the geometry is at its widest around the toe area. Parent the inner foot loc to the outer foot loc, then parent them both under the heel loc. Reparent the toe loc and left toe handle under the inner foot loc. Now you can tilt the foot by rotating either of these locators while still being able to use the foot roll control. Of course, we'll add a custom attribute to the left foot control to give animators control over this foot tilt motion. Name it Tilt. This is another situation, much like the heel, where we'll want to use different locators to tilt in different directions. In this case, we'll want to rotate inner foot loc when the value of tilt is negative, and outer foot loc when it's positive. However, in this case, we can handle it with a simple driven key. Open the Set Driven Key window and use the left foot control as the driver and inner and outer foot locators as driven. First, set a key on the default Tilt attribute and on both locators Rotate Z attribute. Next, set Tilt to -90. And rotate inner foot loc 90 degrees in Z. Set a key on left foot control and inner foot loc only. Finally, set tilt to 90 and rotate outer foot loc negative 90 degrees in Z. Set another key, this time on left foot control and outer foot loc only. Now you can control the tilt of the foot with this attribute. Next, we'll add the ability to lean the foot on its ball and spin it around its toe. These controls let the animator lean the foot in either direction without lifting it off the ground completely, as well as rotate the entire foot around the toe, which can help add weight and urgency to a move. Add another pair of attributes to the left foot control, named Lean and Toe Spin. Use the connection editor to connect them to the ball loc and toe locs, Rotate Z and Rotate Y attributes, respectively. Note that since we're using Y to twist the foot to the side, we need to change the toe loc's rotation order to ZXY. Now we'll add a bit of toe wiggling, which can give attitude and weight to a simple walk cycle. Add another attribute and name it toe wiggle. Then group the left toe handle to itself. Rename the group toe wiggle group. Snap its pivot to the ball of the foot. Now if you rotate this group in X, the toe wiggles. Connect the rotate X of this group to the toe wiggle attribute of your left foot control. Now you can wiggle the toe. However, notice now if we spin the toe 90 degrees, it flips around. This happens because our group is parented incorrectly, so move it under the toe loc. Now the toe can spin properly. Congratulations, you're now done with your foot controls. Referring to our cleanup checklist, this foot rig is already almost clean, thanks to the work we did on the leg in parts 17 and 18. We just need to hide the locators on the left foot control. In the next movie, we'll begin work on rigging our character's arms.